It is now 4 p.m. on Sunday, and we are just under 15 weeks out. Finishing up some client check-ins. I did some this morning, and then my parents came to visit, and then I walked the dog to take advantage of the break in the rain. And it's supposed to be rainy essentially the next 5 days straight, so I have my blue light on. If you do not have one of these, they are fantastic, especially on the gray days. I don't think they sell like blue lights anymore, but just a general happy light increases your mood and your focus as well. Tonight I have my second week of dance, so getting back into that for our show in July, and that's about it today. I did some non-sleep deep rest before coming back into work to just mentally recharge me so I can show up as the best coach possible for my ladies. And what I really need to focus on this upcoming week, if you watched my Q&A video, someone asked me what would I do differently in my previous prep, going to bed and waking up at the same time. I was really good for like 6 days, and I have fallen off track of that. I went to bed at like 1 a.m. last night and got up around 9:30 this morning. So need to provide structure even on the weekends. I work 7 days a week, so weekends versus weekdays doesn't matter. But mentally, I kind of have that because my partner has weekends off, so we stay up later and then we sleep in. But I have less than 15 weeks until I step on stage, the world stage, like the world championships with the best of the best and pros that have been competing for much longer than I have. So I need to get my shit together, tighten things up, and start waking up at a time that is not so late so I can get into a good morning routine and not immediately dive into work. Creating space for you in the morning is really important. Monday morning at 8 a.m., walking the fluffs with a mindset podcast in my ear. Not gonna lie, I had a really sluggish weekend. Got things done, but didn't get them done productively. So just reminding myself it's never too late to hit reset and get back into routine.
How is it May already? Like, I know for half of April I was out of the country and competing in that whirlwind, but how is it May?
Tuesday afternoon, and this is the first time in I can't remember how long that I have had a headache all day, and I'm going to contribute it to my delayed caffeine intake. So normally when I wake up about an hour to 2 hours after waking up and I get my sunshine and my hot tub and my dog walk in, I will have some caffeine and start my day. But I delayed my caffeine. I still haven't consumed it today because I'm going to take it before my blood donation. So I'm going to hit some shoulders and then head over there and be like, please take my pint and lower my iron. Yeah. Caffeine is apparently something that I'm incredibly dependent on right now, and this is not a fun headache, but we can train through headaches. I have been drinking all of the water that I can, and I know that this is a temporary thing. Hopefully some exercise and pushing these shoulders to failure, making them grow, lessens the headache. Could make it worse. Who knows? Either way, we're gonna go out and do our best.
Just through working out, headache got way less severe and then came back when I did cardio, but now it is time to take a caffeine pill. Had a really good shoulder pump, like it still hurts to lift my arms, and then did some cardio, drove to Canadian Blood Services, and now I am eating my pre-donation / post-workout carbs. So I have some blueberries with maple syrup, so quicker sugars to get into my bloodstream. And then the last time that I went, the phlebologist, however you pronounce it, recommended to drink even more water. So I'm trying to chug one of these before I head in. And then afterwards, I have mango to snack on. And directly across the street from the blood donation is my favorite donut place in Barrie. And just because it's there and just because my brain goes, oh, you're donating blood, the donut will help afterwards. No, it won't. It'll cause inflammation in my body. Yes, it'll taste good, but it's not going to serve me. And just because the thought is there doesn't mean that we have to listen to it.
To change up the breakfast game a little bit while my carbs are still high, we're having some Rice Krispies with some oat milk. So cereal for breakfast with a side of air fried chicken because still got to get that protein in. We are back for another training day. Whoop recovery was not good, but makes complete sense when you donate a pint of blood and your body's like, we don't have as much. So resting heart rate shot up, HRV went way down, sleep quality was okay, but like overall I feel okay. And that's the most important thing. Like physiologically, it makes sense why my whoop recovery was low, but I'm gonna show up and I'm not gonna use that as an excuse to pull back on intensity because every single training day counts. We have just under 14 weeks until I step on stage again. And the goal, although in 14 weeks when I'm going to be transitioning back into a calorie deficit, probably not gonna grow a ton of muscle, but we have to keep strength as high as possible. We have to keep training intensity as high as possible to preserve muscle mass. Because if you zoom out, yes, this month I am in more of like a maintenance phase than I am in a calorie deficit. But from December to August, I'm going to be putting a lot of stress on my body. So we need to train hard to preserve the muscle so that as I lean out, I still have everything that I have been working so damn hard for and growing for the past 3.5 years since I've stepped on stage.
So it's Friday and I am outside the gym. I'm going to train, I'm going to do my cardio, and I'm just going to continue with the process because yesterday was not good. I've communicated this with my coach already and I've reached out and I've asked for help, but yesterday was the worst binge that I have had probably in at least a year and a half. All of the hiding food packaging, secretly eating in my car, sneaking away to eat, like all of the things that I have worked so hard for the past 3.5 years to leave in my past came flooding back, and I ate about 7,000 calories. Didn't track everything, tried to go back today and put it all together just so my coach had the information, but like 1,000 grams of carbs for the day, like 225 grams of fat, and I just feel so swollen, and like I want to feel frustrated and I want to feel sad, but honestly right now I don't feel anything. I'm kind of at this like numb level where it's like, okay, that happened yesterday and we just need to continue on with the process because more I'm 14 weeks out and I don't even know if I'm competing. Like that was the whole trigger for yesterday. I did all of my finances and my accounting and stuff for 2022 tax season and got back the number of the money that I owed the government and then was crunching numbers of what I paid to compete last time in Florida versus competing in Vegas and the cost of all of that. But I've already paid for my hotel, which is non-refundable. I've paid for a photo shoot, which is non-refundable. I've registered, which is non-refundable. I have put a deposit down on my theme wear and my bikini. So my brain is all over the place right now, and I know that I will figure it out. And I know after waking up today and feeling as garbage physically as I do and not feeling anything mentally, that I don't want to do that again. There's a reason that I moved past it, and there's a reason that I healed my relationship, and that's it. So that workout, got it done. Just kind of went through the motions, still pushed myself as hard as I could, increased weight for the majority of my exercises to keep that progressive overload. If anything, all of the food from yesterday, sure, it made me feel a little bit slower, but I could definitely feel the difference in how I was able to perform. And now there is a promo going on with the Sun Emporium called Spray May, where they're giving away free spray tans. So I'm going to go get a spray tan, just an act of self-care, and make the existing muscle definition that I do still have pop a little bit more.
Today, I am giving myself a slow and compassionate start to the day. So one of the big takeaways from my mindset team and my coaching team is post show, like I have been go, 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 go. My nervous system needs a little bit of recovery. Even though I'm still in prep, I just need to
be a little bit more compassionate with myself and take it one task at a time and know that I'm going to get everything done. And with the extreme overeating on Thursday, I'm still puffy, I'm still inflamed, but today is better than yesterday, and that's what I need to celebrate. And reflecting back on everything that I journaled about and that I discussed with my support team, wins to celebrate. The binge was only one day, and I reached out for help right away. So in previous reverse diets, one binge day would turn into three, would turn into five, would turn into, fuck it, I have undone all of my work, so I'm just going to keep eating my feelings. And this is different because I don't want to go back there. I've learned from my mistakes. And yes, patterns and reflexes are going to come up again, but I need to celebrate the wins, and I need to get excited about getting back on track so quickly. And I'm going to keep in contact with my support network every single day this week especially. And that's something that I practice with my Lady the F Up clients that haven't had the best week, is I'm going to touch base with you every single day this week to shift that backwards momentum forwards again. Because once that forwards momentum starts going, it's a lot easier to keep it up. So here is to the shift. It's just going to get better from here. I got 10 hours in bed, 9 hours of sleep, feeling better. My resting heart rate is still really high. My HRV is still really low, but that is the stress on my body, both the digestive stress and the physical stress and the mental stress of dealing with, oh my God, what have I done? So again, taking stay a little bit slower to bring that down. Work on stress management and be compassionate with myself and celebrate the wins, because one off day was just one off day, and now it's time to get back on track.